My wife and I are lifelong sailors, both of us. We've always enjoyed and loved sailing, and we were in a new place, the eastern Bahamas, called Eleuthera. And everything was normal. I had really no indications of anything being wrong. Went to bed, and I woke up about 4:35 in the morning, and I absolutely had no feeling at all in my left side. Total deficit. I didn't feel my arm, my face, my legs, my chest. I couldn't speak. And there was a doctor there, fortunately, and they got me off the boat to shore and met him, and he looked at me immediately and said, "This guy's had a stroke. He has to get to Miami right away and get stabilized." And they flew me via air ambulance with a nurse to Toronto, and I took a transport to Hamilton General. And then I was transferred to the rehab center after about a week.
Jim was referred to us for upper extremity rehabilitation to help with motor recovery of his left arm and hand. Through the treatment process, it came to light that one of Jim's goals was returning to driving.
I think my personality too is very, I'm sort of a driven guy and a goal-oriented guy, so I was always in my plans to get back to work and get back driving, and that again was very important to me.
The driving simulator's design and scenarios were derived out of years of evidence-based research. And what it does is it provides us with real-life scenarios of driving situations, so we can assess how a patient would approach those, but also create a treatment plan with them.
They kept talking about the simulator. It was going to come, and Michelle thought I would be a good candidate, so I gave it a whirl. And. I mean, you go in, it looks like the Jetsons space age thing, and with the computer monitors and even the seat adjustment, and you know, there's blinkers and gas pedal and brake, and it's very, very realistic.
For patients like Jim, using the driving simulator can really help to restore their independence. Having an opportunity to try out these real life driving scenarios within a safe environment, in Jim's case, allowed him to see what it would feel like, right? And build his confidence related to returning to driving.
It was a big confidence booster to be able to do that. And again, little things in stroke recovery mean so much. Well, it's the world, it's just that independence back and that, you know, not having to rely on everybody all the time to get you here and there and pick you up and get you to appointments and things. Yeah.
It feels great. It's like invigorating. It's freeing. I feel free.